Good day, you are welcome to our moment of recovery. And by the grace of God, as we continue to look at the recovery of the lost family, today what we want to look at as a step toward recovering of the family that God created is God's factor in Christian marriage. God's factor in Christian marriage. I would like to start my reading as I will read the book of Genesis and chapter 1 verse 18, and then I'll quickly move down to Genesis, the same chapter. I'll read verse 22 and 23. And the word of God says, "The Lord God said, it is not good for a man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him." Let's go to verse 21. "So the Lord God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep, and while he was sleeping, he took one of his man's ribs and then closed it up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made the woman from the rib he had taken out of man, and he brought her to the man." And that is the word of God. And my prayer for everyone hearing me today, that God's own home, the home that God created, will be your portion in the name of Jesus. But I want you to notice the word of God, and you will discover that it was God who identified the need for marriage in the life of man. You will also notice that it was God also who took the lead in the creation of the woman that will be suitable for the man. And I just want you to know that if you really want to have the kind of home that the Bible is talking about, God must be the most important personality in your home. I want to raise these few things with you, and then we pray. The first thing I notice is that it was, just as I said before, it was God who noticed the need of a wife for the man. It was God who noticed. That's the first thing. And I'm telling you, friends, for all of us who are trusting the Lord to have our own home, please, before you take a step of choosing a woman for yourself or a man for yourself, please remember that it must be by the leading of God. It was God who noticed it. The man was busy. The man didn't see any need to have a woman by his side. He was just busy doing his own work. But God noticed that without a woman in his life, he will not be able to fulfill God's purpose. So God decided, you know, to take note of that, and God also went forward to make a promise. And that is the second thing I want to raise with us also. Again, it was God who promised to create for him a suitable helper. He said, "It is not good for a man to be alone. I will make a suitable helper." And I want you to take note of that word suitable. That is to say someone who is qualified to take care of the man's need. What a powerful promise. And I pray for that man that is seeking the face of God for a woman in his life. God will give you a suitable helper in the name of Jesus. And I don't know that man whereby your wife have started behaving the way it shouldn't be. I pray for you also that God will create out of that woman a suitable helper in the name of Jesus. So I noticed that. The third thing I noticed was that God went further, and he took out of Ada the woman that he desired, a woman that will meet himself. And I'm telling you, friends, no wonder the book of Proverbs says, "He who finds a wife obtained favor from the Lord." It is God's favor that will give you the woman of your life. It is God's favor that will lead you to get a man that both of you will live together until death part you away. God performed a miracle. And what was that miracle? He brought a woman out of the man. No wonder the man called her name, saying, "She shall be called a woman." That is, a man that was taken out of a woman. So I pray that God is going to help us. So that is the next thing. The next thing that happened is that God also, and you will see the next thing that happened, it was a divine instruction. So that is we are unable to read it, but I will read it to us, verse 24 of Genesis chapter 2. That is why a man leave his father and mother and unite to his wife, and they become one flesh. That is another powerful thing. A powerful miracle, two people coming together and they become one, having the same mind, having the same spirit, having the same body, whereby they don't see any difference between each other. Why? God gave a divine instruction. What is that divine instruction? A woman to leave his father, mother, and they join together so that both of them will come together and they will be able to become one. I'm telling you, friends, it's only God that can make a Yoruba man united together with an Igbo lady, and they will become one body. It will only take God. It's under God that that can happen. And I pray that as many of us who are married from different culture and there are issues, that God will unite us together in that name. And the last thing I saw, which is very essential, is that God continue to visit them. It's just like God, you know, decided to say, let me begin now to monitor these two people that are brought together. You will see that in Genesis chapter 3, verse 8. The Bible says that the evening of the time, God will come down from heaven and have fellowship with the people. First, as we pray today, God's factor is essential. Number one, because God owns marriage. And just as we have been told, and I pray that God, by his power, is going to help all of us in the name of Jesus. Can we pray together as we call this God who is involved in our marriage to pay attention to our home? Let's all pray. Let us pray. In Jesus' name we are praying. Our Father, we say thank you for what we have had, and I commit that home under any form of devilish attack, that you will deliver that home in the name of Jesus. A place where the man and the woman couldn't see each other eyeball to eyeball. Father, let there be settlement in the name of Jesus. I pray you will grant them the grace to raise for you godly children in the name of Jesus. And the name of the Lord shall be glorified. Thank you because you are fathers. In Jesus' name we are praying.